Well, good morning everybody and welcome back to another film. So today's film is for me a situation that I'm sure many of you can relate to, and that's only having a limited amount of time to get out and take photographs. And not only have I got a limited amount of time today, but I've also only got a limited day in the week when I can get out this week and shoot, and I'm sure that's familiar with lots of you. So I'm not going to pressurize myself, I'm just going to enjoy the morning. And like I say in so many films, it's not about the photographs you take, it's the experience you take away with you that really matters on any one particular photographic outing, and I'm certainly going to enjoy it today. So when I checked the forecast last night, the forecast was for no cloud, just pure sunshine for the whole of the first part of the morning. So with that in mind, I decided to wait. I knew where I wanted to come today, to this lovely old woodland, and the forecast was for a bit of cloud to build and get a mixture of sunshine and cloud. So there's lots of lighting opportunities for me there, and who knows what I might be able to take advantage of, maybe even backlighting or some nice soft overcast lighting. Lots of opportunities presented by the lighting conditions. So as always, just my regular wander through the woods, enjoying the early bird song as it's starting now at this time of year. We're right at the end of March and the birds are really getting going, so I'm going to enjoy that this morning. But yeah, have a walk round and see what jumps out at me as always, and we'll capture hopefully some nice images. And if it's not a case of nice images, one image will always do me to take away. So I will see you shortly. So already I'm starting to see potential shots, and I've got something in my mind's eye. I'm not sure whether it's a brave thing to do at this point, but I've got an idea of something in my head that I want to photograph if I can find it. And what it is that if you look to the sides of the path that I'm stood on my right, your left, you've got lots and lots of fresh ramsen wild garlic growth, and the leaves coming up, beautiful this time of year. And then on the right-hand side of the camera, we've got the little white flowers of the wood anemone. And the shot I have in my mind is the leaves, the palmate leaves of the wood anemones contrast beautifully with the single leaves of the wild garlic, the ramsons. And if I can get a combination where those two leaf types are together and complementary to each other in a very nice, clean way, and hopefully if I can do that along with maybe some of the flowers of the wood anemone as well, bringing those three elements together in a single frame would be really beautiful. Now the problem is, I have walked up and down here, and whilst we've got plenty of all three elements, I can't find the combination where all three come together within a single frame. Now I do know that this river valley continues for some considerable distance, and there'll be other opportunities like this along that walk that I'll do this morning. But the best thing to do in these situations is to log the image in your head and hope you find it, rather than be too reliant on looking for it, because the chances of finding it will be like hitting the lottery really. And whilst it would be really beautiful to bring that image to the video, in reality it'll be quite a difficult thing to find. So I'll be concentrating mostly on the things that do jump out at me as definite images, rather than the ones I've sort of orchestrated in my mind. So keep looking. Now it seems I cannot take my own advice, because when I last spoke to you, that image was so fixed in my head that I had to come down here and look for it. Now I've been to this location, I know it well, and last year I actually filmed some wood anemones just at the back of the tree trunk over there, so I'll put a link above to that video. So this particular spot I know has got an awful lot of ramsons, and I know that they do coincide with the wood anemones, more in clusters of one or the other, but I did think that there was a chance that I might just find what I'm looking for. Now, I haven't found exactly that, but what I have found here is a single wood anemone just peeping through the vegetation of the Ramses. Now, before you doubters begin to say it is attached, it is rooted, and I will show you that when I've taken the image. So I've not placed it, if that's what some of you are thinking. I never ever do that. What I have done is I've just moved one or two of the Ramsen leaves just out to one side, just to give a clear view, or a clearer view, let's say, of the flower head of the wood anemone. So I'll get the camera out and give that a go. I think this might actually work really well. So I spent a bit of time getting the actual composition just right, tweaking it, and what I've done is actually a focus stack of about five shots, and I've done two variations of that with just some slight minor adjustments to the camera angle. So I'll just show you the actual shot now. So here we have basically the composition, and it's quite a small crop of this area just here. And if I move the camera in, bearing in mind that this is a 16x9, the crop that I've got isn't too far off that there. And I've shot the whole thing at f16, and like I say, a focus stack of about five images, starting with the flower. And then what I did was I moved over to this leaf here, and then I did the focus stack following this leaf down, because it went down to quite a deep point of the image. And then just lastly, I actually focus stacked with this leaf down here at the very, very bottom to make sure that all the leaves were nice and sharp throughout the image. Now, as I said right at the beginning of the film, this plant is attached. You can see just here, hang on, just there down at the bottom, it is attached, and I've not placed it. So I'm going to put that shot on now, and hopefully it's somewhere close to the actual vision that I originally had, but it's certainly a nice looking image. Three and a half, possibly 4 meters, literally from the last shot that I just took of the wood anemones there. When I was working on that, this little pool here caught my eye, and what's happened is that the river's been up and it's receded, and the flood water has left a nice area of foliage, sort of decaying leaves that have fallen from obviously the trees above. And we've got a mix of oak and predominantly beech leaves. And just that the way they're all flat on the surface and breaking down on the surface really caught my eye. So I've had a look round for various compositions, and I've settled on one here where you've got an open pool in amongst the leaves on the surface, and underneath that are more leaves. So it's almost like an underworld under the decaying leaf matter on the top, and I quite like that. And again, they've got a nice mix of these lovely brown tones on the surface. As with that shot, which I didn't mention, is that 100mm macro, and again, it's a focus stack, this image, of two images, one for the surface leaves and one for the leaves that are submerged below. F16, quite straightforward, just making sure that the sensor plane, the back of the camera, is nice and level with the surface of the little pool here. Very, very simple, straightforward shot, but a nice abstract nonetheless. So I will put that on now and then make tracks and see if we can find something a little further afield. think it's time to move on. And just to sort of discuss what I'm looking for now is I've got an image that's got lovely rich green, deep green tones in it, and I've got the lovely golden tones of the leaves in the little pool just there. So as with a number of my videos of late, I've been presenting the images at the end as a triptych, sort of a group of three. So I can find either one with golden tones or one with green tones and put the odd one out in the centre and show them as a nice display at the end. So that's what I'm probably going to be really looking out for going forward this morning. Now, some of you will have probably noticed that there's an image right here where I'm standing, and lovely leading of the Ramsons going down the river valley beyond. The main reason I'm not photographing that is because I think this one will be a good one to come back to later on in the spring. This particular plant, for those of you that don't know Ramsons wild garlic, they get some lovely flower heads that stand proud of the leaves there, and all this will be a sea of lovely white, and I think that will be the best time to come back to this shot, just in maybe 2 or 3 weeks time. So grab the bag and I will see what I can find. I'm going to head that way, probably, I don't know, 200 or 300 yards, and I think that's probably going to be it for me. So hopefully I'll find something to complete that little bit of a triptych that I've got planned for the end. So those of you that watch this channel regularly will know that this is a position that I often adopt, and it very often means that I've found some poo, which many of you find quite hilarious, but not the case today. But what I have found is really quite interesting, and things like this really help bring context to my photography and help me feel more connected with nature, because over the years I've learnt how to understand all the things that I find and basically what makes the habitats tick. So I don't know whether you can see what's in front of me. Just literally at the other side of this root here is a pellet, and this, many people actually think that this is poo, but it's not. This is regurgitated out from the stomach, and this particular pellet belongs to a tawny owl. Now, lots of birds produce pellets, but this one, I can tell by the size of it, it's about the size of my thumb, is a tawny owl. Now, another pellet that you often see this size belongs to the barn owl, but barn owls typically live in old barns and they forage in open grasslands and meadows. They don't spend any time in woodland, so I know that this is a tawny owl. It's quite degraded. When they're fresh, they're usually jet black and quite shiny. And this one's probably about 2 to 3 months old. They really don't last very long at all in the open. Now, it's made entirely of fur and bones. The fur binds the whole thing together, and as it degrades, the bone fragments start to show from within it. Now, you can actually buy a book that, and if you get under a microscope, you can get the little jaw bones that you find in these, and you can identify the mammal species, the mammal species that the birds been taking as prey. So really quite interesting, helps to build a story about the woodland and how the birds feed on the various different species. So I'll put that back, somebody else may find it, but definitely tawny owl pellet, definitely not poo. It's funny how things never quite turn out as you expect. So the nice brown toned image and the rich green image that I had in mind to form a triptych, the third image that I thought would be one of either hasn't really turned out that way, certainly not yet, but I've found another image to be getting on with, and it really is lovely, and I've had to sort of thread my way in amongst these wood anemones, trying my best not to damage any of the foliage. And my camera, I can't get it so low to the ground where I need to be, and I haven't brought my beanbag today to place on the floor. So I very craftily positioned my leg between the two foam legs of the tripod and then pinned it with the top leg here just in the position that I want it to be. And I'm photographing these two anemones here, the flower heads, and I've got a lovely narrow depth of field that just emphasizes just these two, focusing primarily on the stamens of the one on the right hand side, and all the background is lovely and diffused. For those of you that are interested in the settings, I've got this set on 5.6 and it's a 100mm macro lens. And just to remove any movement in the flowers, they're actually not moving now, they were blowing a little bit a minute ago, I've actually upped the ISO to 800 to make sure that I get the sufficiently fast shutter speed. And I'm working on a 500th of a second as we speak. So I'm going to take that one out and put that on, and hopefully it's not the last image of the day and I can still find the one that will complete my triptych at the end. So here we go. So really quite excited by my next find, and just here on the left hand side, the trunk lying on the floor, I'll get this camera out and place it over the composition and just talk you through what I've just seen. So this composition really caught my eye. What we've got here is a felled section of Scots pine, and at some point the bark has been knocked off or fallen off, decayed, and revealed all these threads beneath the surface. And what I really love about this is that, bearing in mind that this is an actual trunk of a tree, the shape of these threads actually almost look like they're mimicking the shape of a tree in their own right. And I love the way that they come down into this little cleft just here, and that will form the base of my composition. So it will come out here and up, and I'll be careful not to crop off I want to crop off the tips of the threads so that you're just focusing in on the shapes. This will certainly fit the triptych that I'm looking for, the brown tones, the second image of brown tones that I'm looking for to create the three images at the end of this film. One slight niggle, of course, is you may have noticed there's a section of the threads here being knocked off at some point, but I think the image is so nice, I can live with that. I think it's well worth photographing as it is. So I'll get the camera out now and get it framed up. So the camera is all set up, I'm currently on live view, the focus is set, the composition is aligned. For those of you that are interested in settings, I'm on 100 ISO because nothing's going to move on this one. F16 to give me lots of depth of field and retain nice sharp detail, and a fifth of a second. And the lens, like with all images so far this morning, have been the 100mm macro. I have got a polarizer on currently, but rotating it has got very, very minimal effect, but I have just put it to the point where it saturates the colours the most. So 2 second timer, and I'll put that image on now. Well, that's it from me for today, folks. Images to come at the end. Thank you all so much for joining me in this beautiful spring woodland today. If you have enjoyed the content and you want to see more, please don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell for notifications. Press the like button, give it a thumbs up, it's always good for the channel, and leave some comments below. Let me know what you think of today's images. So until next time, I will see you all very soon. Bye for now.